a very special day where this project is launching, so she's going to tell you all about it. Well, Pia will tell you more.
Thank you so much for coming today, and I also wanted to thank two special people that we have in the audience. One is Shiva. Thank you so much for designing these beautiful sets. And They Sing for coordinating so many animators over the last year to create these animations. Hello, media friends. Thank you so much for coming here today. It was 1 year ago that we last met, and we had the dream of creating these animations for the children of India. And today, there are 78 countries using our materials. Our research began in India, and India has been a very special place for us. And we're so glad to be back here to announce, for the very first time, the release of 12 versions, so 6 new language versions of the animations. And we're doing that national India launch here today from Chennai with all of you. So now we want to give you a first look, a behind-the-scenes look of the making of Teach Aids with a number of our celebrities, which will come on the screen here. And Nikhil will make sure that the video is available for you, the high-quality version, so that you can download it and use it on your stations as well. Educate about these very serious topics. And with that, we'd like to show you a few clips of the animations. We'll start with the Tamil male version, which has Surya and Siddharth, followed by the Tamil female version, which has Anushka Shetty and Shruti Hassan, and lastly, a clip from the English male version, which has Mr. Amitabh Bachchan and Imran Khan.
For being here with us. I'd like to take you back to 2009, when I first met Pia. So, the newspaper headlines, I live in Hyderabad, so the newspaper headlines had splashed all over, and the television channels were splashing that the children who were HIV positive had been expelled from their schools in Hyderabad, which was shocking. It was shocking, it was disturbing, it was a serious social problem. And the government and all the HIV prevention society of the government, NGOs working with HIV positive people, lots of friends from the media, everybody came together to attend a public debate. It was a public debate where the parents and teachers who had instrumented this expulsion of these children and the rest of us who were going to speak in support of it. And this debate went on for 3 to 4 hours. The media all spoke very positively, trying to convince the parents. We all spoke, we debated and debated, and at the end of it, maybe about 60% of the parents agreed that what they had done was wrong and they could take the children back. And 40%, of course, didn't. But what everybody agreed to was there was no material available. So in 2009, despite all the investment the government had put into HIV prevention, there was still no material available in the system to educate children and parents and teachers at the school level. Everything was available for adults, but nothing was available for schools. So this was extremely disturbing. They said, give us the material. It's because this material is not available that this situation has happened. So I went home that day very, very dejected that such material was not available. What were we going to do? And the same time, my husband came home one day saying, you have to meet this young lady called Dr. Pia Sarkar. So In my experience, that when a certain social problem arises, the universe always sends a solution. So I believe the universe had sent India Dr. Pia, who has her roots in India,